This new travel advisory out from the federal government, warning Canadians not to travel internationally if they don't have to, advising against non-essential international travel. That's from Ottawa. There is further guidance coming out from the Public Health Agency of Canada, and John Northcott takes a closer look for us at what they are advising there. John?
Heather, it all springs from what we heard the health minister say yesterday, which was, quote, now is not the time to travel, full stop, end quote. That is reflected in the documentation that we're seeing, and we'll show you here as we scroll it up on the screen. It goes on and on and on and on in terms of what you should know before you're traveling, when you are traveling, the precautions you should take, the information that you should have at hand, the documentation, and perhaps most importantly in all of this, what you may encounter and what you should be prepared for. Again, this is assuming that you have taken the step and arguably ignored the advice of the federal government and have gone to travel. Again, this is the non-essential stuff. Essential, presumably, but still, even if it is essential, you can encounter the same concerns that they're outlining in that. And there's a quote in there, and we'll put that up for you, because it really does underscore not only the fact that those returning to this country may encounter a number of challenges in terms of what we already were required to have in terms of that negative PCR test, and now testing at the point of arrival that'll be ramped up, at least for anyone coming from a non-US destination, not ruling out potentially that could be ramped up as well. But the idea that you could be effectively stuck in some part of the world for an indeterminate amount of time, again, in the words of that release, the information they have all springing from this advisory around what you should avoid as a traveler, and it's everything from the whole wide range of venues. And when you think about it, they're the sorts of things that one does when you do go abroad, and you go abroad to take part in these kinds of things. So live performances, avoid bars, avoid sports venues, avoid crowded transportation in any other way. Well, unless you're going to some desert location, you're probably going to encounter a lot of those circumstances. In fact, that may be what motivated you to travel in the first place. So all of that warning against the travel. Also pointing out that in these various locations, not only could you be restricted from leaving the country itself, you may be restricted from being within the country. That could affect your access to health care. So check whatever health insurance you have, check your travel insurance, all of this. And one final note to pass along in all of this, they point out that air carriers have the right to refuse you entrance onto their planes if you show, in their opinion, any signs of having COVID-19, and they can keep you off that plane for 14 days. So all of that, again, around the returning to this country, sure, restrictions and rules, they've been in place for some time, but the whole idea that out there in the big wide world, the circumstances could change, and effectively, from the government's point of view, you've been warned.